While I was in London, I spoke with a guy who's been promoting Japanese music for more than 20 years. And he told me it's not just J-pop that's popular.
Far Side Music introduces Japanese and other Asian music to fans in the UK and the rest of the world. The man behind Far Side Music is Paul Fisher. He lived in Japan for 11 years.
When I went to Japan, I kind of thought, well, for the first time, which was at the end of the 1980s, I think 1989, I found some things which appealed to me, which I thought might cross over, were some Minyo singers, but who were doing something quite new with it. So they were singing in a style which was very definitely Japanese or Asian sounding in the way that they sung, but it also included rock elements, Western elements, and it was a mixture, such as nene. The more I've kind of delved into the history of Japanese music, there's always been this mixture in Japanese music. Even if you listen to some of the greatest Japanese singers like Hibari Misora, you know, she was combining some Minyo music, maybe with some Latin rhythms. So music of the 1940s and the 1950s, I think, is actually some of the greatest Japanese, what you might call, world music that's ever been produced. And I find that actually now people are getting more interested in that period of music.
Here are some of Far Side Music's most popular Japanese acts.
Discovering all kinds of Japanese music out of the UK.
And not just current music, but like Paul Fisher illustrated, there's a tremendous background in Japanese music back into the 40s that had a lot of global influence, and I never really thought about that. So we learned a lot from watching that.
Right, like the Latin style.
Influence, yes. And Misora Hibari-san used to sing a lot of jazz songs.
Really?
And there was a boom of a lot of Latin mood music within the Japanese Enka for a while.
Yeah.
I think in the 60s.
Really?
So that's an interesting field that he discovered.
After my visit to London, I went to another